Chapter 10, Viewing Statistics. Another thing that you're going to want to do when it comes to Snapchat is find out what kind of statistics you can get and how you can use them to make your brand better. Unfortunately, Snapchat doesn't really offer any sort of detailed analytics or anything to tell you who is visiting your story page, but it does have some statistics that you might find useful. In this article, we're going to go over those as well as tell you about the alternatives that are cropping up that may give you the analytics information that you need. There are several metrics that Snapchat offers you. The first one that we're going to discuss here is the total unique views that a story has gotten, and stories are the only analytics that we will discuss here because that's what you will be using as a marketer, and also it is the only feature on the site that Snapchat offers analytics on. Total unique views tell you how many people opened up your story and saw at least the first frame. They may not have gone on to finish the story and in fact may not have even went past that first frame, but it tells you how many people opened up your story and it is very accurate. The thing about stories is that you can see how many views are on every single frame of the story, or on the video if you created a video, and that's how you get these total unique views. You go to the first frame and look. The second analytic that we're going to discuss is total story completions. You get your total story completions by going to the very last frame of your story and taking a look how many people finish your story. Make sure that you're keeping track of these metrics as you see them, and also keep in mind as this will be after the 24 hours that your story has been live. The third analytic is probably the most important of all of these, and it's the completion rate, which you'll figure out yourself by looking at your total unique views compared to your total story completions. So for example, if you had 1,000 people start your story but only 450 completed it, you would have a 45% completion rate. The higher that your rate is, the better your story. Finally, the fourth analytic that we're going to discuss is the stopping point. You want to look at your snaps and try to figure out if there is a trend as to when they stopped watching or viewing your story. If you can detect a trend at a certain frame, then you will have discovered where the problem was, which means the problem was somewhere up to that point, not necessarily the frame that they stopped on. Companies that are providing analytics information. There are a few companies out there that are providing analytics information for Snapchat. They have only popped up recently, but they have some innovative programs and several have very good reputations with businesses that are looking to market on Snapchat. If you want to find out what is going on with your Snapchat account and have detailed analytics so that you can make the best decisions possible on what to post and when, as well as what's working and what isn't, then you might want to look into using one of these companies. Just do your research and make sure that other people are recommending the service and that the price isn't outrageous compared to the going rate. Chapter 11, Using Snapchat at Live Events to Get Followers. In this chapter, we're going to discuss a couple of ways that you can use live events to get followers to your Snapchat account. The first thing that you should do is open up your Snapchat app and look where the Discover page is. You will see a place where it says Live, and then you will find Stories below that. Don't get confused by this live event feature that Snapchat has. They do a thing called Our Story where they pick a live event that's going on and then take people's snaps and video from that event and build a curated story that everyone can see regardless of who they are following. That is not the type of live event that we'll be discussing in this chapter. The type of live event that you want to use Snapchat for is the kind of live event where your company is doing something exciting that customers can attend. You can hold these events whenever you like, and you can use Snapchat to both bring people to your live event and convince people that are already at your live event to sign up and follow you on Snapchat. The way that you get people from your Snapchat to your live event is fairly straightforward. Just build a story using snaps in that event and invite people out. Just remember, stories last for 24 hours, so the best way for you to do a live event with Snapchat stories is have the story begin before the live event starts, 24 hours before the start of your event. Then you can start a brand new story when the event starts and people will be able to check out live images and video from the event. Obviously, this is a great way to get people to your event because you not only get people that have to prepare for the event and are willing to come 24 hours after hearing about it, but you also get people who are more of right here right now, fly by the seat of your pants people. In other words, people who will come to your live event on very short notice. It is worth noting that this will only work if you have followers in the same city that you are doing the event in, and if you are a large brand and you are in a large city, this is usually not a problem. For small businesses, many of their followers will have followed them by coming into their brick and mortar store, and so they will not have a problem either. In fact, the only people who are going to have a problem are the people who do not have a brick and mortar store and only work online but have a very small business and not a huge Snapchat following. Holding a live event will be very poorly attended because very few of your Snapchat followers are likely to be in that particular area. In either case, whether you are convincing people to sign up and follow you on Snapchat from your live event, or you are trying to convince followers in that area to come to your live event, you should definitely use some sort of promotion, coupon or giveaway to entice them. Chapter 12, Delivering Personal Content Through Snapchat. This chapter is designed to give you some ideas on how you can deliver personal content to the people who follow you on Snapchat, including what kind of content you can deliver and some ideas for some great personal deliveries, as well as tips on how you should deliver them. This is something that you would do individually with your followers and is designed to work with a promotion that you have going on. For example, suppose that you posted on your website that sometime in the next few days you are going to give away a certain number of free items or gift certificates, but that the people who would receive them would be followers on Snapchat whom you sent a personal snap to. What you should do next is choose a specific day during that week and even choose the hours that you will be doing it between. Then you can ramp up your advertising efforts a little during that period because you know that the people that are following you on Snapchat are paying attention because they want to get a free item and they will read your stories more frequently. This is just one way that delivering personal content can help your business. Another way that you can use personal contact to grow your business is by thanking customers when they purchase something from your website by sending them a snap and then create a story with those snaps. This is a great method because all it requires is that you asked people on your order form to put in their Snapchat ID. There are many different ways out there of using personal communication to grow your business. You can try to get referrals from the people who are currently following you by creating a story that tells them that they will get something at a huge discount or for free if they can get a certain number of people to follow you on Snapchat. You may have to have them post on another social media network. Twitter is the best option, because you may not see it on Snapchat if they snap and send you the name of a user that followed you based on their recommendation. You can ask them to post the person's Snapchat ID on Twitter with a specific hashtag, and then you can check your Snapchat followers to find out if that person has joined that day, and then you can then give them credit for the follow. Chapter 13, Give Followers an Inside Look. Another great way that you can use Snapchat is to provide your followers with some behind-the-scenes information or an inside look at something that you're doing. This has a number of benefits. First and foremost being that the people who follow you on Snapchat will pay closer attention to your snaps and stories and will keep your business in mind if they need your product or service because you are already in their mind. But another benefit is that if your behind-the-scenes information is exciting, and whatever you're building or doing is compelling, people are going to want to share it. There are lots of ways that you can use this. First of all, make sure that all of the other social media you use knows that you're posting exclusive scenes information on Snapchat. That means that if the followers from your other social media platforms want to see the behind-the-scenes information, they are going to become followers on Snapchat as well, which gives you more followers. You can use this several ways to get followers every time you have something that you can show behind-the-scenes information of. You can even drive traffic to your own website using Snapchat. If you snap and build stories, you can place a method for getting to your website within the story as well as a reason for them to go there, a call to action that is going to give them some sort of benefit. You always want to make sure that you have some sort of benefit to offer them. One great way to use Snapchat to get some long-term results is to direct them to your website and have them sign up for your mailing list. That means that you can now send emails and people will look at an email much longer than they will a tweet or a snap story most of the time. The main thing here is that you just make sure that you are always interacting with your audience. If you have something that you think that would be great on Snapchat, make sure you put it on there. Make sure that you take every opportunity that you have to give people that follow you on social media some sort of inside information about your company or something that they didn't have before. If you want them to do something and follow a call to action, then make sure that you are offering some sort of benefit to do so as well. Chapter 14, How to Run Contests and Promotions on Snapchat. Snapchat is a great place to run contests and promotions. Many of the other businesses that are on Snapchat use this method to both say thanks, usually with discounts, and to get more followers by stirring up some excitement. So, how do you run a contest or promotion that will do well on Snapchat? In this chapter, we'll explore some of the ways that you can use this type of marketing on Snapchat and some of the benefits that you can get from it. Designing your promotion. The first thing you're going to have to do is design your promotion. You need to figure out what kind of things are going to require from the customers or followers and how you are going to set it up logistically. For example, they could add you as a friend on Snapchat and then you could request them to create a video or take a snapshot and send it to you. Promoting your promotion. Now you're going to promote your contest. You can promote it in your brick and mortar store, on your own website and on the other social media platforms that you use. There are all kinds of ways that you can promote your contest, but you do want to keep in mind that you have to let your followers know in a very clear fashion if you decide to use their videos later on in a future promotion. Checking your contest entries. The next step in the process is checking your contest entries. For example, if you had your users send you videos, one of the things that you can do to make sure that you see all of the entries is to use a third-party program to view the videos and save them to your phone. You are probably aware by now that if you use Snapchat and someone sends you a video or a snap, it is going to self-destruct in no more than 10 seconds unless they build a story with it, in which case it will be gone in 24 hours. From there is just a matter of figuring out who the winner is in your promotion or however you designed it, with multiple winners or with everyone receiving some sort of promotional code, however you choose to create a fun and exciting promotion that your followers will like. If you can do this, you will find that the followers that you have will be much more apt to check out your snaps and videos as well as stories when you post them. Chapter 15, Aligning Yourself with Niche Influencers on Snapchat. One of the ways that you may not have considered marketing your company with Snapchat is to use niche influencers. This is actually a tried and true method of marketing and it is something that big companies do quite often. Some companies have partnered with YouTube stars in the past who work in the same niche as them, such as cosmetic companies pairing up with extremely popular makeup tutorial YouTubers, and so it is a very good way to market your company. What are niche influencers? So, what are niche influencers? They are people who have a lot of influence over a large number of potential customers within your own niche. Niche influencers often have large followings that go out and buy their recommended products and trust them implicitly. When it comes to anything that they use personally, followers will go out and buy that particular product in droves, which is why brands send popular YouTubers free samples of their products all the time. Benefits of using niche influencers. There are a lot of benefits to using niche influencers. For one thing, you are going to have a chance to entice their audience to come over to your particular company when they need a product or service that you provide. For another, the name of your company will be going around within circles that make up your industry. How to use niche influencers. So, how should you use niche influencers? There are many creative ways that you can do this. Some people send them free samples of whatever products or services that they are selling, as long as that particular influencer is in your industry, that is perfectly acceptable, and others do things like allowing a well-known person to take over a social media account. In fact, that is something that has been quite a trend recently. How to find niche influencers. Finding niche influencers within your particular industry isn't all that difficult. You can use websites like Clout, Peer Index and Cred or any of the other barometers of influence that are out there. You can also check social media and find out who has a huge following within your particular industry. There are various ways to go about this depending on what social media platforms that you use, but you definitely should check Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, and Facebook. Of course, you may be able to find out who the niche influencers are within your industry that are also on Snapchat. Chapter 16, Measuring your success with Snapchat. So how do you measure your success with Snapchat? Knowing whether or not a campaign was successful will depend on coming up with creative ways that you can figure out whether or not something worked. For example, if you did a Snapchat marketing campaign and you asked the users on that platform to do something on a different platform, then it would be very easy to measure your success, or at least the numbers. However, there is more to success than the numbers, and we'll get into that here. First, let's talk about the numbers. Obviously, the numbers are important. But there is a great deal more to be aware of. Before you can get into any of that, however, you need to know the numbers, and so you are going to have to come up with some method of figuring out how many people you reached on Snapchat and how many of them took your call to action and actually follow through with signing up for an email list, posting a tweet with a certain hashtag, or whatever particular method that you are using. You can make use of the Snapchat tools that were discussed in the chapter on analytics, as well as your own methods of counting people that have responded. Now, let's talk about the demographics. So, you are going to have to figure out some way that you can get demographic information from the people that are responding to your marketing campaigns. Demographics are super important when it comes to campaigns, because if you know what type of people have responded to a particular product or service, or advertising campaign, then you know how to improve it next time. Demographics can be difficult to get, and the best way is probably to go with one of the companies that were discussed in the chapter on analytics, because there is really no way to get that information with your own efforts. Now, let's talk about user response. The last thing that you want to measure is how the users felt about the particular marketing campaign that you did. You want to know what they thought of the campaign itself, and also, you should try to find out whether they were happy to sign up for your mailing list because the offer was terrific, or whether they were on the fence about it. Finding out how users responded to a particular marketing campaign can go a long way in helping you improve future marketing campaigns and get better responses. Chapter 17, Learning from Other Brands on Snapchat. You should definitely learn from other brands on Snapchat. There are several ways to do this, but with the platform constantly evolving and with new marketing ideas coming all the time, it can be a little time consuming to keep up with everything. However, you do want to make an effort to try to figure out what other companies are doing, particularly the biggest companies, because those are going to be the easiest ones to find and will save you a little time. Figure out what other brands did and then come up with methods that work just as well. In this chapter, we're going to come up with some ways that you can find out what other brands are up to and learn from them. News articles. If you follow marketing news, you are definitely going to find people talking about Snapchat. With 2 million active users per month, there are a lot of people with their eye on this particular application who want to see where it is going, particularly since the company refused Facebook's offer. So if you look at the marketing news websites where you set up your new search for Snapchat, you should be able to find some great information on what some of the major brands are up to when it comes to Snapchat. Ask other people in the industry. Another thing that you can do is ask other people that you know are in the industry. Regular communication with professionals like yourself that are within the same industry that you are in will allow you to share a great deal of information with each other that you might not have had on your own. People that are within your own industry are easy to find, and unless they are a direct competitor, they're probably going to be very happy to discuss their methods. Follow marketing blogs that are all about the trends. Find some great marketing blogs that have good information and then sign up to get regular updates or an RSS feed from them. Bloggers will do quite a bit of research regularly, and so they may be able to get information before you can on some of the trends that are going on in Snapchat. You can use Google search to find bloggers who concentrate particularly on Snapchat and on the marketing that goes with it. Chapter 18, Integrating Snapchat with your site and social media. Depending upon what type of site you have, adding Snapchat to it could be very easy or could be quite difficult. There are so many platforms out there now for creating a website, and content management systems like WordPress are not the only players in the DIY world of website creation. In this chapter, we're going to discuss how you can integrate Snapchat with your website and with your social media. If you have a WordPress website, being able to integrate Snapchat will depend upon the theme that you have. While all of the current themes definitely have places for Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and others that are more well known, Not very many of the themes out there have automatic places where you can put your Snapchat information. However, you can put your Snapchat ID and even your QR code on the sidebar of your WordPress site by using a text widget. If your website is built from scratch with HTML, then you may have to get your web designer to create a place for your Snapchat QR code and for the user information that you want to post on your website. You should definitely put the QR code in the header of your homepage so that people can easily take a picture of it and try to follow you on Snapchat whenever they visit your website. Integrating your Snapchat into your social media is going to take some creativity on your part. There really isn't any place that you can post your QR code and Snapchat information on Twitter. The only thing that you could do is replace your profile picture with your QR code, but this is probably a bad idea for several reasons. 1. Twitter might not be happy that you are using a competing social media site's QR code on their site, and Snapchat might not be happy about it either. There is also the fact that you should have a decent profile picture on your Twitter account. One idea that may work on both Twitter and Facebook is putting your QR code within the background. In Twitter, that means the background that your tweets are sitting on, and on Facebook you would have to put it in the larger header profile. Just make sure that you aren't being obtrusive so that the social media website doesn't have to you about putting a QR code from a different social network onto their site, which they usually don't. And don't forget to remind people within your social media feeds as well as integrating it into the platform. Conclusion: Snapchat is one of the most interesting social platforms that has come around in a long time. The way that it allows users to communicate only through pictures and video is very interesting, and it will be fascinating to see how the platform develops in the future. Marketing on Snapchat is something that people are starting to do more and more, and companies are spending a significant portion of their marketing budget on speaking to those people who use Snapchat. In this book, we've gone over some of the reasons that you should use this social media platform and even took you through the entire sign-up process so you can get your account online. We also showed you how to create your QR code, which you will be able to use on all kinds of things like your website, the wall of your brick and mortar business, other places you decide to put it like your business cards, and even other social media platforms. Some of the highlights of the other areas that were discussed in the book include taking you through the process of building stories and showing you how you can get fans by using the stories, as well as how you can get your initial following. There was also a great deal of information on using analytics and how you can use the numbers for Snapchat gives you to measure your own success. You can also use the analytics companies that are out there that promise to give you detailed information about your marketing efforts. Finally, we went over several ways that you can use Snapchat with other social media platforms and things like live events, as well as give you some ideas on how to get followers, like using brand influencers. It is our hope that the information in this book will allow you to start using Snapchat and be able to use all of the features successfully without any problems. While there is no guarantee that a marketing campaign on Snapchat will be successful, there must be a reason why so many companies are starting to use Snapchat to do marketing. Since other people have found a great deal of success and companies are spending $750,000 a day just to be listed on the platform, odds are good that you will find success as well.